So I decided to go with really, really big hair. I was thinking about not curling it, but I changed my mind and I'm very glad I did because I really like the way my hair came out. And even my mom said it looked pretty. My mom never compliments me. So it is so hot in here. I am so sorry, but if you hear my fan throughout this video, you know why, because it is boiling and I don't know why it's boiling at this time of year, but it is boiling. I'm like about to start sweating. Oh my God. So today I'm gonna be showing you how I got this makeup look. This is gonna be my birthday makeup. I am turning 22. I just did this pinky gold cut crease, as you can see. So if you want to see how I got this makeup look, be sure to just keep on watching. I really hope my fan isn't super duper loud over there. But I started off by prepping and priming my face. I used my LA Girl primer and, you know, my Olay as a moisturizer. I am gonna be putting up an eyebrow tutorial though. I promise November I'm gonna post an eyebrow tutorial. I've been promising forever and I've never done it, but I am going to do it in November. So if you wanna see that when it comes, just be sure to subscribe to my channel and it's coming, I promise. So today I'm gonna use my Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation all over my face. Actually, you know what? Since I don't want my makeup to last all night or all day, I'm gonna start with my Ben Nye powder and I'm just gonna set my face before I put on my foundation. Oh look, I'm using my favorite brushes. I've been using them lately. Actually, I only used them twice since that other video that I made. My pink halo look. Ugh. But I mean, this is a special occasion, right? My birthday. Oh yeah, I didn't even tell you guys how old I'm turning. I'm going to be 22. Surprise, right? And I usually don't do anything for a birthday, and I don't know what I'm gonna be doing this year because obviously I'm filming this before my birthday and it's gonna go up after my birthday. But I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm sure I'll figure it out. Maybe if I do something, I'll insert some clips at the end of this video. We'll see. I'm not gonna like promise that. So now I'm gonna apply my Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation and it's almost finished, so I'm just gonna like basically swoop some out. Like usually when I get to this point of foundation, I just like throw it away. We'll stop using it, but honestly, this is a lot of product. I've been using this, I've used this like 3 times already to do my face and I still have like a bunch, so I'm like maybe I should stop wasting it and make use of it. So I'm just gonna put some on my blemishes. I really don't have much blemishes, but my skin has been scarring lately, which I hate, and I really gotta like figure that out. I forgot what the whole point of saying that was. I realize every time I put on my foundation, it looks way darker than my chest area. But first off, my skin is way lighter, I mean, way darker. My face, get it together. But first off, my face has always been darker than my body. I don't know why, but that's just the way it is. But like once I do the rest of my face, it just all comes together. Like, I promise. Like my decorations, I thought for my birthday, you know, this is a pink look. I just put some pink in here and I just love these. I think it looks so cute, especially with this like little, my leaf, my fall leaves. It's gonna be here for the next 2 months maybe. Just been liking decorating my background a little bit lately. Like now that I've started, I'm like, I can't go back. It's too good to go back. But it's only $1, so it's okay. But I only use them once, so I'm just gonna have like a stack of like props. Cause now I have that, so I have these, I have that. Fine, maybe I can use them again on Valentine's Day. Who knows? So first, I'm gonna highlight my brows using my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Toffee. Now I'm gonna highlight over my eyes and meet in my brows. I actually really like highlighting my brows with this shade now. I think think one of my videos, I was like, when I first did it, I was very unsure about using this color under my eyebrows. But I was just like, oh, it's too light. But since doing that, I've actually like added that to my eyebrow routine, which you'll see. It's a little bit dark right there. So now that I've finished concealing my eyelids, I'm going to take the same Ben Nye powder and I'm just going to set the concealer. Highlight my face and conceal. I'm in contour. Or do I want to start on my eyes? I think I'm going to start on my eyes because, you know, sometimes you gotta wipe it off. Okay, guys, so today I want to do a cut crease and I need all of you to cooperate. It's not even the cut crease part that's hard for me. Actually, maybe it is. I'm going to use my 88 color matte eyeshadow palette by BH Cosmetics. And I'm going to use this color right here, this right there, that one. And I'm going to use that as my transition shade. That. You know what, first let me zoom you guys in. The only complaint about this eyeshadow right here is that it's a little bit grainy. I mean, like, you can kind of, like, even see the graininess in the palette, but apart from that, it's really good. I mean, like, you don't feel the graininess on, but it just, like, looks a little grainy. So the next shade I'm going to use is this one, the one right next to it, a little bit darker shade of pink. Now time to do that cut crease. I'm going to use this e.l.f. concealer brush and my Toffee concealer. So yeah, I'm just going to bring it up to like half of my eye. It's like about right there. Just let it free. Jamie Genevieve was like, whenever in doubt about your cut crease, take a selfie and then compare it. But I can't find my phone. I didn't even realize it wasn't in here. One of these eyes is a little bit higher than the other. Which one is it? This one. Is it? Because it would flip, right? That would be this eye, and that would be that eye. Yeah, this one's a little bit higher. But I prefer it to that one, actually. So, how am I gonna fix this?
I'll tell you how.
I'm gonna use this flat eyeliner brush from e.l.f. I'm just gonna like line that to make it a little bit further down. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna make that eye match because that's actually a really pretty color on top of the concealer. When it goes wrong, but it also goes right. Why is it so dark? Because the sun keeps changing. Okay, so I went ahead and tested out that on one eye. So I'm going to show you how I got this on this eye. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tap this, my brush in here, like once or twice, just taking up a little bit of color. Then I'm going to go with the H&M palette and I'm just going to do swiping motions on top of it and dust off the excess. Yeah, I'm just going to pack that color on the entire concealed part. Now I'm going to go back to my BH palette and I'm just just gonna carve out that same lighter pink crease right there. I'm gonna take up the same color that I just used on that crease and I'm just gonna put it all on the outer edge. I'm also gonna bring that color up onto the shadow. Now I'm gonna take the first brush that I used for my first crease shade and I'm gonna also put that first crease shade on top of the lid and bringing it in about a third of the way. And sussy. And now for the cut crease, I'm gonna make a really, really, really fine line, making it just above the pink that we put. I'm just gonna use this NYX Liquid Crystal Liner in the color Dramatic Sparkle. What is that word they say? Caution. With warning, this isn't meant to put on your eye. They said it's not for your eye, but I put it on my eye and you know, I'm fine. So, and honestly, I don't know what else it would be made for. It has a liner applicator, so I'm like, what is it for? So I have put on some lashes now. I'm gonna go ahead and start concealing and highlighting and contouring. So as usual, I'm gonna use my LA Girl Pro Concealer. I'm gonna contour with my LA Girl Pro Foundation. Always make that mistake. Guys, if you ever see these chips in a store, I suggest you try them out because they're so freaking good. Well, it's upside down. But like these chips, they're called chippies. And they're just these Jamaican banana chips, and they are just so good. And now, I'm gonna use my Ben 9 again and set my highlight. So now I'm gonna use my True Complexions palette, and I'm gonna contour my face. I already did it, but my camera cut off. I don't know if it caught that. I'm just gonna spray some setting spray. So I'm just gonna line my bottom waterline with this Kiss Professionals matte eyeliner. I'm gonna go back in with my 88 matte palette and I'm just gonna put some of that powder under my. Before I do anything else, as I usually do, I mean, you know, the video is coming to an end. I'm gonna line my lip. I'm gonna apply some blush and highlight. For blush, I'm gonna use my Blush Neutrals palette, and I'm going to be using this pink shade right here. My highlight, I'm obviously, you know, the usual, I'm gonna use my It smells like Cheerios in here. I don't know why. So I'm going to use the color Beeper on my lips as a base for my actual lip color. Okay, so now I'm gonna actually top it off with this True Matte by NYX AK, or NYX AK, and this is the color Millie Brock. So I'm just gonna put that on top of it. So wait for it to dry completely before I even like smack my lips together or anything, or else it'll be spotty or splotchy or whatever. I think it should be dry now. So I'm going to use my same sheet pencil and I'm just gonna line that. I swear the only matte lipstick that I really like is ColourPop because it's so perfect. It's literally just so perfect all the time.
I could never fall.